Hello all. We're going to go through some of the demos today in morphing optimization and concept development discipline. Here is the agenda. Form, extrude, sweep, loft, and joints library. These are the ones. Form tool. This tool helps in bending the parts. You can use the screen handlers. So in the graphics window, there will be some of the handlers you can utilize and bend the parts. We have the bumper assembly here, and we're going to select the bumper. So the application, what we are going to see here is we're going to bend the bumper and the rails are actually going to follow. So right now we selected the bumper, all the elements are selected, and right away these handlers popped up. So these handlers, you can utilize them to bend the bumper. So at this point, we are going to go ahead and hide the bumper so that we can select only the rails as part of our transition zone. So transition is nothing but based on the lead of the bend that happens, the rails will follow the lead of the bumper. Right now, we are fixing the ends of the rails so that they stay where they are and they do not, you know, get into the rear parts of the rail. And we are going to provide a constraint which is already defined here. So this is a directional constraint, which is nothing but it helps in making sure the rails only move or get morphed along the x-axis or the fore raft direction only. So here you can see the checkbox of allow local X movement is checked on so that the rails are only moving along the fore raft direction. So we're done with the definition. So ANSA is now prepping to digest the definition. And at this point, we'll see what these handlers are going to provide us with. So this double-headed arrow or the handler, you can use it to provide the input of the angle. 2-degree angle we provided, it's going to morph. So the lower end got morphed. We also can save this definition that we created. So once we save, you can utilize it as a, you can parameterize it, and then you can perform DOE also. So we saved it. You can find it in the database here. We are right now going ahead and pulling up the save definition. So at this point, you might be wondering why the symmetric side of it is not morphing. This link option is actually gonna help in morphing the left and right hand side of the vehicle. So right now we are giving the input again using the handlers. So around 2 degrees. And you can observe at this point, the morph is happening on the right side also. The enable button here, that's gonna help switch back and forth between the baseline and the morph state. So at this point, it's trying to morph back again. So that's how you can check baseline and morph state. We'll see the other handler here. So this is a length handler. So what this does is you can focus the bending operation on specific region. So here at the center of the bumper, what we are doing here is we are focusing the bend only at the center. The length is 172. That's the length. The bend is focused and the other area just follows. So we'll see it in a different view just to see. So the center area is, you know, between the handlers is where the bend happens, and the subsequent areas, adjacent areas, they follow. So right now with a bigger angle, you can see this in an elevated manner. So the center area is gonna bend more, but the subsequent area towards the left hand and right end of the vehicle, it's just gonna follow. So that's how you can bend parts with this tool. We'll look into the next demo here. So this one is extrude. So if you have a cross section and you want to create a part out of it, you can use this tool to create a part. So we have a floor here and a cross section already created. You can create it, this cross section in ANSA from scratch. So extrude tool, you can just pull that cross section away from the plane and you get this preview. Up to functionality, if you have a target and you want the member to be reaching there, you can select the target and the member reaches there. And the next one we are going to look into is a two-sided member or a part that we can create from the cross section. So right now we are extending it in on right side and then left side. So you can have an unsymmetric part. So one of the applications we'll see right now is we are going to create a cross member on this floor and create the flanges. So if you observe on the right end and the left end, the flanges are not created yet. We are going to create them. And on top of that, all the flanges will adapt them to the floor. So symmetric is the option we are using right now. So using symmetric, both sides of the cross-section plane, we are extending the member. So the member, you might be wondering why we created a member so that it's intersecting the floor. So ANSA has this function that helps in creating flanges when you have T-joints, or in other words, triple cones. At this point, we are going to intersect the cross member and the floor. So that way we have a T-joint formed on either sides of the cross member. So the intersection is done. We are trimming off the unwanted areas. So we are trimming off that portion also. And we are keeping the remaining portions, which we definitely need. So currently, the floor and the cross member, they both are connected. And there are T-joints. Let's see them. So let's zoom in here. It will showcase the blue lines. These are the T-joints here. So the cyan color or the triple cones, we all say. So ANSA has this unique functionality, the flange. So in the faces menu, there is flange option. It can automatically detect these T-joints or triple cones. And it will not only create the flanges there, but also it will try to adapt those flanges to the floor that we can see here. So shortly, you will see the flanges. And up here, you can observe the flanges are actually adapted to the floor also. And additionally, if you want to control some of these parameters, you can do that too, so that you can modify those flanges that got created. At this point, we are done with the generation of flanges and also the cross member. The further steps, we are going to adapt these flanges, the longer flanges that we have to the floor. So we have meshed it and released the cross member. So you can observe the mesh. And the gap, you can see the gap between the longer flanges of the cross member and the floor. So we have a new function called hat flange. So at this point, we are selecting these longer flanges and the target or the contact as per this function is the floor. As transition, we'll select the remaining portion of the cross member except this top area. So there should be a certain vector provided. So this vector is the direction along which the flanges will move, searching the target. So we made a two-point selection to create a vector. And as a next step, we are going to accept this definition. And the flanges, they are going to go adapt. So you can see the flush here. If you want the offset, you can provide the offset also. And once you look at the preview, you can go ahead and accept the definition. So at this point, you can see the stamp and the bead. The floor flanges, sorry, the crossmember flanges are adapting to the floor geometry. So that's how you can create a crossmember and make the flanges adapt to the floor. And subsequently, you can go ahead and create these spot welds or adhesives, whichever you want. So moving on to the next one, sweep. You might be wondering in the previous demo, whether you can create a part going along, a specific curvature, or in other words, the profile of it, whether you can change the profile or have a curvature. So here we have a curve that defines the curvature. You can sweep a cross member across this curve we have. And right away it shows the preview. As soon as we say okay, it will create a geometry out of it. So all these definitions we saw till now, they are saved in the database, and you can go ahead and modify the cross section and regenerate the geometry also. So the next one we'll be looking into is loft functionality. With loft, there are actually two different applications with this particular function in ANSA. So the first one we are going to look at is using loft, you can create parts passing through several cross sections. So here you can see the B-pillar, there are four panels and there are multiple cross sections. So for each of the panel, there are corresponding segments out there. So there are four set of segments. And on the right side, what we are gonna look into here is just the body side outer, how we are gonna create from the multiple cross sections. So it's just simple selection, selecting the set of segments that are made part of the body side outer. And some of the options here will give you a preview of how the geometry is created. Same steps, basically the geometry, you can observe it. There is a quite a bit of variation in the geometry and the cross sections. And you can compare both of the results. They look to be identical. So that's how you can, if you have input of multiple cross sections, you can make the geometry pass through all cross sections and get the complex geometry out of it. So the earlier I told you that there are two applications that the loft can be used for. So the second one is the subsequent one that we'll see. If you have topology optimization results, you can go ahead and create members out of your result using this functionality. Here we have the topology optimization result, couple of cross sections in the database. So the loft wrap is the functionality. Right now we are gonna select the cross section. Here we have a double hat section. So we are gonna hover our mouse here onto the result. So, and we can snap that cross section that we picked wherever we want. At this point, you can manipulate this cross section. You're gonna scale it. So ANSA automatically has the scaling option, but we are manually scaling it. Right now I have up down flange. If I want the crosscar flange, I can do something like that. And as subsequent steps, I'm selecting the for the cross sections to make my members here. And once I'm satisfied, I'm gonna accept it. And the thing that you're gonna observe or need to focus on is the center cross section is actually kind of smaller than the either ends. We already saw that one of the ends, we scaled the cross sections, but on the other end, we did not. The automatic scaling option on the right side bottom is what has actually provided this capability. So ANSA has this capability of automatically adapting to the geometry out there, and it will scale the sections as needed. So this is how you can manipulate your topology optimization result and come up with members, that makes sense and move on to your next set of analysis. So with that, we'll move on to the joins library here. So this library can be used to bring in joins from the previous concept designs and use them for the new concept designs you might be working on in future. So shortly we will see the demo. Here we have the body side outer, the lower B pillar join. This is the library. So in the library, there are several vehicle joints. Since I need the lower joint, I just brought in the lower joint here from vehicle A. If you observe in here, there are morph boxes on the joint. So there are some morph strategies, which we will shortly look at. So we can go ahead and morph this joint and then fit this joint to the surrounding geometry, to all the sections out there, three-way section. Once we have fitted this, we do not have the mesh connected here. So you can observe how the mesh is. At this point, we'll go ahead and use the FEM topo functionality to connect the joint to the adjacent area here. So the tolerance is provided and the mesh is connected now. So you can observe the nodes, how they are connected. Obviously, you can go ahead and reconstruct that area. So this is how you can use the previous vehicle joints. Excuse me. So use the previous joints and then adapt them to the new geometry you have for the new concept designs. So that's it I have for you today. Thank you all.